أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين، ولا سيما بقية الله في الأرضين وحجته في العالمين، واللعن على أعدائهم من الآن إلى أبد الآبدين. Greetings of peace. السلام عليكم أيها المؤمنون والمؤمنات ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. I've put a challenge to the Omri scholars that I'm waiting for them to face me in a series of debates on the issues that we differ on, that we have difference of belief on. And I've been waiting and waiting and waiting for the last 7-8 years. And the only thing I see from Omri scholars is hiding and running away and making funny excuses. This reminds me of a very, very well-known incident that happened in the history of Islam. At the Battle of Siffin, Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam called upon Muawiyah to face him for a battle. And Muawiyah sent Amr ibn al-As. Amr al-Ba'as, when he came to face Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam, what happened? I'd like to read that from their own books, from the books of the Umaris. Inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, I'll read from a number of sources, inshallah, from their books. This is Al-Isti'ab fi Asma' al-Ashab lil Ibn Abdul Barr. Ya Allama Abi Umar Yusuf Ibn Abdul Barr al-Qurtubi, published by Darul Fikr at the year 1427 at Darul Fikr, Beirut. At this book, the author mentions that he has وَاعْتَمَدْتُ فِي هَذَا الْكِتَابِ عَلَى الْأَقْوَالِ الْمَشْهُورَةِ عِنْدَ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ بِالسِّيَرِ وَأَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ بِالْأَثَرِ وَالْأَنْسَابِ وَعَلَى التَّوَارِيخِ الْمَعْرُوفَةِ الَّتِي عَلَيْهَا عَوَّلَ الْعُلَمَاءُ فِي مَعْرِفَةِ أَيَّامِ الْإِسْلَامِ وَسِيَرِ أَهْلِهِ. On this book, I have depended and relied upon the well-accepted and well-respected narrations before the scholars of history of Islam. And those scholars who know narrations and they know genealogy of Arabs, and those who know the events that happened in Islam and their history and their background. So he claims that all of the things that he has mentioned in this book, they're all narrated from respectable sources and from accepted sources of narration. At page 104 of this book, at the Bab of Busr, there was a certain Sahabi of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His name is Busr ibn Artat. Busr ibn Artat had some, is a very, very shady character. Although he's a Sahabi and he has narrated from the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, nonetheless, he's a very, very bloodthirsty person. Amongst the things he did, he killed Quthama ibn al-Abbas, or Ubaidillah ibn Abbas. He was the governor of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam in Yemen. Muawiyah dispatched Busr ibn Artat with a party of raiders to just loot and kill anybody on their path. So he came to Yemen when Ubaidillah ibn Abbas, or Quthama ibn al-Abbas, that I've forgotten now, he heard that this person is coming for looting. He left because he did not have enough manpower to face him, perhaps. For whatever reason, he left. His family went into hiding with the local people. He had two young sons, very small young sons. When Busr ibn Artat arrived in Yemen, he asked about where is Ibn Abbas. They told him he has left. He found out his family is hiding. He called, he found and searched for the little two kids. He beheaded this Sahabi, beheaded those two little kids in front of their mothers. And this is a very well-known incident. At any rate, that's not the purpose of mine that I am quoting this book. And the Battle of Siffin, and these raids of that Muawiyah conducted, they were after Siffin. after Siffin, but during the lifetime of Amir al-Mu'minin عليه الصلاة والسلام. وكان بصر بن أرطاط من الأبطال الطغاة. بصر بن أرطاط was one of the very valorous and brave and bold men of Arab. وكان مع معاوية بالصفين and he was with معاوية and صفين. فأمره أن يلقى عليا عليه السلام في القتال وقال له. معاوية ordered بصر because he was brave and a very well-known fighter to go and fight أمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام in a man-to-man fight. And said, سمعتك تتمنى لقاءه فلو أظفرك الله به وصرعته حصلت على دنيا وآخرة. Busr, he said to Busr ibn Artat, go and fight Amir al-Mu'minin alayhi salam. I've heard that you have expressed your wish, that you wish that one day you will face Amir al-Mu'minin alayhi salatu wasalam and the foray and the war and the battle. If you are able to throw him down and you, if you are able to end his life, you kill him, then you and you, I'll give you the world. And akhirah, the hereafter is all. You have it anyways because you are on the side of Haqq and you are fighting the batil. And that was their position anyways. وَلَمْ يَزَلْ بِهِ يُشَجِّعُهُ وَيُمَنِّيهِ حَتَّى رَآهِ. And Muawiyah kept insisting and encouraging. Go fight Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. I will give you this, I will give you that. And promise them rewards. فَقَصَدَهُ فِي الْحَرْبِ فَالْتَقَيَاهِ. So Busr ibn Artat looked for Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam in the battlefield and found him. And he faced Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. فَصَرَعَهُ عَلِيٌّ رِضْوَانُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ. Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam threw him down from his horse or from his ride. He threw Busr on the ground. وَعَرَضَ لِعَلِيٍّ كَرَّمَ اللَّهُ وَجْهَهُ مَعَهُ مِثْلَ مَا عَرَضَ فِي مَا ذَكَرُوا لِعَلِيٍّ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ مَعَ أَمْرَ بْنِ الْعَاصِ. Busr ibn Artat, بصر ابن أرطاد عرض. I should read this as عرض لعلي كرم الله وجهه مثل ما عرض فيما ذكروا لعلي عليه السلام عمرو بن العاص. بصر ابن أرطاد when he was thrown down from his ride from his horse and he was certain that أمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام would dispatch him to جهنم, he did the same thing. He exposed himself in the same way that عمرو بن العاص had exposed earlier. What was that exposure of Amr ibn al-As, then he mentions. بلي. وذكر ابن الكلبي في كتابي في أخبار السفين. Ibn al-Kalbi has narrated in the book of in his book of the narrations of Siffin that Busr ibn Artat بارز عليا رضي الله عنه يوم السفين. That Busr ibn Artat faced Amir al-Mu'minin عليه الصلاة والسلام in a one-to-one fight in the battle of Siffin. فطعنه علي عليه السلام رضي الله عنه فصرعه. So أمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام struck him with a sword or with a spear and threw him down from his horse. فانكشف له. So this man, Busr ibn Artat, he exposed his private parts because he knew أمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام was a man of حياء, a man of dignity. And if he did such an action, undertook such an action, Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam would not kill him. كما عرض فيما ذكروا مع عمرو بن العاص. And the same thing, Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam happened between Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam and the famous Sahabi Amr ibn al-As. This also happened in the Battle of Siffin. ولهم فيها أشعار مذكورة في موضعها من ذلك الكتاب. And the Arab poets have said many poems with respect to this incident, with respect to this very, very interesting incident whereby Amr ibn al-As saved his life by bending over and exposing his buttocks. And in the midst of the battle in front of both armies, so he is not killed. منها فيما ذكر ابن الكلبي والمدائني قول الحارث ابن نضر السهمي. A very famous and well-known Arab poet, Harith ibn Nadr al-Sahmi, has said these lines. أَفِي كُلِّ يَوْمٍ فَارِسٌ لَيْسَ يَنْتَهِي وَعَوْرَتُهُ وَسَطَ الْعَجَاجَةِ بَادِيَةِ. Every day a warrior. This thing doesn't end, that every day a warrior comes in the midst of the battle, he shows off his butt. He shows off his rear side, his behind. يَكُفُّ لَهَا عَنْهُ عَلِيٌّ سَلَامُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ سِنَانَهُ وَيَضْحَكُ مِنْهُ فِي الْخَلَى مُعَاوِيَّةِ These warriors, they came and they exposed their behind. So Amir al-Mu'minin Ali alayhi salatu wa salam يَكُفُّ عَنْهُ سَنَانَهُ He turns away with his spear. He turns away his spear from them because this man has exposed himself, so he does not kill them. وَيَضْحَكُ مِنْهُ فِي الْخَلَى مُعَاوِيَةِ And then Muawiyah laughs at this issue in private. Muawiyah laughs that Amr ibn al-As saved his life by exposing his behind. بَدَتْ أَمْسُ مِنْ عَمْرٍ فَقَنَّعَ رَأْسَهُ وَعَوْرَةُ بُسْرٍ مِثْلُهَا حَظْوَ حَاذِيَةِ Yesterday, Amr exposed his behind. So Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam covered his eyes and turned away. وعورة بسر مثلها حظوة حاضية and the backside, the rear side of بسر بن أرطاد, the other Sahabi, is very much as in the similar fashion. He also exposed it in the very similar حظوة حاضية in the very similar fashion. فقولا لعمر ثم بسر ألا انظرا سبيلكما لا تلقيا الليث ثانية. So say, oh my messenger, say to Busr and give my message to Amr, to watch out, سبيلكما لا تلقي الليث ثانية. Watch out, do not face that lion, that valorous man, that brave man, Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. Do not face him a second time. ولا تحمدا إلا الحياة وخصاكما. خصاكما means the genitals, the backside, the buttocks, what they call in slang English, American English, the ass. And do not praise anything but Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam's dignity, his honor. Do not praise and thank anything but Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam's dignity and his honor and his haya. وَخُصَاكُمَا and your own asses. Thank your asses. هُمَا كَانَتَ وَاللَّهِ لِلنَّفْسِ وَاقِيَةِ But I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam's honor and his dignity and his haya and your backsides, your rear ends, they are responsible for saving your lives. ولولاهما لم ينجو من سنانه وتلك بما فيها من العود ناهية متى تلقى الخيل المشيحة صبحة وفيها علي فاترك الخيل ناحية وكونا بعيدا حيث لا تبلغ القناة نحوركما إن التجارب كافية. ولولاهما لم ينجو من سنانه وتلك بما فيها من العود ناهية. If not for Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam's honor and his haya, and also if not for your own rear sides, you too would not have been saved from his blade, from Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam sword, from his spear. Sinan is the spear. وتلك بما فيها من العود ناهية. And this is a good enough reason for you to not ever return to the battlefield. So never return to the battlefield because you saved your lives once. Because of what? Because Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam is honorable and because you exposed your asses. So do not come back to the battlefield. متى تلقي الخيل المشيحة صبحة. Meta, when the two raiding armies, which with loud noises, they meet each other in the morning. When the two armies face off each other and engage in battles in the morning. وفيها علي فترك الخيل ناحية. And أمير المؤمنين, if أمير المؤمنين عليه السلام is present in that battle, you too go away. Go away from the horses, go away from the fighting parties. Go away to a side, don't be present there. وَكُونَا بَعِيدًا حَيْثُ لَا تَبْلُغَ الْقَنَى نُحُورَكُمَا إِنَّ التَّجَارِبَ كَافِيَةً. Go away far. Go away to a place where the blades and the spears and the swords do not reach your throats. إِنَّ نُحُورَكُمَا إِنَّ التَّجَارِبَ كَافِيَةً. Experiences enough. You had enough experience. You experimented once. You faced Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam, and he... And you saved your lives by exposing your butts. And this has been mentioned in so many different books of history, my dear viewers. This is Wafayatul A'yan. Wafayatul A'yan, written by Ibn Khallikan. Wafayatul A'yan wa Abna'u Abna'i Zaman, written by Ibn Khallikan, a very respected and a very esteemed and very knowledgeable historian of the Umri congregation. Third volume published by Dar al-Sadr. In this book, in the lifetime of Abdullah ibn Abbas ibn Abd al-Muttalib, in his biography number 338, page number 62, he mentions that once in a certain event after the demise of Amir al-Mu'minin alayhi salam, during the lifetime of Muawiyah, the reign of Muawiyah, Abdullah ibn Abbas faced Abdullah ibn Abbas, who was the cousin of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Amir al-Mu'minin alayhi salam, saw Amr ibn al-As. He addressed Amr ibn al-As with these statements. فَأَقْبَلَ عَبْدُ ibn Abbas عَلَى عَمْرٍ. Abdullah ibn Abbas turned towards Amr ibn al-As. فَقَالَ يَا عَمْرٍ إِنَّكَ بَعْتَ دِينَكَ مِنْ مُعَاوِيَ وَعَطَيْتَهُ مَا بِيَدِكَ. Amr ibn al-As, you sold your iman to Muawiyah and gave Muawiyah everything from honor or iman and faith and piety you had, you sold it to Muawiyah. وَمَنَّاكَ بِمَا بِيَدِ غَيْرِهِ. And Muawiyah promised you that he will give you things that Muawiyah does not possess. It's not his possession. For instance, the Baytul Mal in Egypt, the treasury in Egypt, it's not Muawiyah's, it belongs to Muslims. He promised you to make you the governor of Egypt. فَكَانَ الَّذِي أَخَذَ مِنْكَ أَكْثَرَ مِمَّا أَعْطَاكَ. What Muawiyah took away from you and you gave to Muawiyah is greater than what Muawiyah has given to you. وَالَّذِي أَخَذْتَ مِنْهُ دُونَ الَّذِي أَعْطَيْتَهُ. And what you have taken from Muawiyah is very small, is scant. Very, very insignificant compared to what you have given to Muawiyah. وَكُلُّ رَاضٍ بِمَا أَخَذَ وَأَعْطَى. And you both are happy. You are happy that you gave your iman to Muawiyah, and Muawiyah is happy that he got your iman and gave you the governorship of Egypt. فَلَمَّا صَارَ مِصْرُ فِي يَدِكَ كَدَرَهَا عَلَيْكَ بِالْعَزْلِ وَالتَّنْغِيسِ حَتَّى لَوْ كَانَتْ نَفْسُكَ بِيَدِكَ أَلْقَيْتَهَا. And when Muawiyah gave governorship of Egypt to you, then he did not stay quiet. He started scheming against you and making your governorship difficult over Egypt. So much so that he made it so difficult for you that even if he wanted to take your life away, you would have given him your life. He made your life so miserable. وَذَكَرْتَ مَشَاهِدَكَ بِصَفِّينَ. Amr ibn al-As, you mentioned to me that you were present at the Battle of Siffin. فَوَاللَّهِ مَا ثَقُلَتْ عَلَيْنَا وَطْأَتُكَ. I swear by Allah, your presence in Siffin was not very important for us. It had no significance for us. وَلَقَدْ كَشَفْتَ فِيهَا عَوْرَتَكَ. And you are the same person who in the Battle of Siffin, who exposed his backside, who had exposed his rear end. Your presence in Siffin is insignificant, doesn't mean anything. وَإِن كُنْتَ لَطَوِيلَ اللِّسَانِ قَصِيرَ السَّنَانِ. You have a very sharp tongue, but you do not have a sharp sword. You do not have a sharp spear. آخر الخيل إذا أقبلت وأولها إذا أتبرت. You are at the end of the army when the army comes. And you are at this forefront when the army returns. When it runs away, you are at the forefront. You are the vanguard. You are the first one to run. لك يدان. You have two hands. يد لا تبسطها إلى خير وأخرى لا تقبضها عن شر. You have two hands. One hand which is never extended towards anything good. And another hand which is never taken back from evil things. ووجهان. And you have two faces. وجه موحش ووجه مويس. You have two faces. One face of yours is very, very terrifying. You have a face that's very terrifying, very horrible. And another face which causes anybody despair. With another face which would cause anybody to despair and lose hope if he sees you. وَلَعَمْرِ أَنَّ مَنْ بَاعَ دِينَهُ بِدُنْيَاهِ غَيْرِهِ لَحَرِيًّا أَنْ يَطُولَ نَدْمُهُ. And by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I swear, any person who sells his iman, his faith, for the dunya, for the government of another person, such a person is worthy of a very lengthy remorse, a very lengthy nadim, remorse, to be remorseful and to regret, a very lengthy period of regret. لك لسان وفيك خطل ولك رأي وفيك نكد ولك قدر وفيك حسد فأصغر عيب فيك أكبر عيب في. These were the words of Abdullah ibn Abbas. At any rate, Abdullah ibn Abbas mentioned in this narration to Amr ibn al-As that you are the same person who had run away in the Battle of Safin and who had exposed his rear side so he is not killed. A very famous Umari scholar, Ibn Kathir al-Dimashqi, the author of Al-Tafsir al-Qur'an al-Azim, the author of Al-Bidayah wal-Nihayah, the student of Ibn Taymiyyah. He also narrates this incident in his book Al-Bidayah wal-Nihayah. This is the book of Bidayah wal-Nihayah, Lil-Hafidh Abul Fida, Ibn Kathir al-Dimashqi, third volume, published in Darul Fikr at the year 1429, Darul Fikr, Beirut. In the Battle of Uhud, the martyrdom of Hamza alayhi salam, page number 107. وقد فعل ذلك علي رضي الله عنه يوم الصفين مع بوس بن أرطاد لما حمل عليه ليقتله أبدى له عورته فرجع. أمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام, when he faced Amr ibn Busr ibn Artat in the Battle of Siffin, Busr ibn Artat exposed his rear side, so Amir al-Mu'minin عليه الصلاة والسلام did not kill him and he turned away. وكذلك فعل عمرو بن العاص حين عمل عليه علي عليه السلام في بعض أيام صفين. Likewise, did the same thing was done by Amr ibn al-As when Amir al-Mu'minin عليه الصلاة والسلام charged at Amr ibn al-As in one of the days of the Battle of Siffin. أبدى عن أورته. Amr ibn al-As exposed his rear side, his behind. فرجع علي عليه الصلاة والسلام أيضا. So أمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام turned away and did not kill Amr ibn al-As. ففي ذلك, and then he mentioned the same poem that I recited to you from the book of Al-Isti'ab لابن عبد البر. One of the great scholars of the Umri congregation is Ibn Abd Rabbihi Al-Undulisi, the author of Al-Iqd al-Farid. This book is Sir Alam al-Nubala by Al-Dhahabi. Volume number 15, published at the Risala Foundation in the year 1417. At this book, at page number 283, he mentions the biography of Ibn Abd Rabbihi, the author of Al-Iqd al-Farid. Ibn Abd Rabbihi. Al-Allama al-Adib al-Akhbari. He is a great scholar, literarian, and he is a narrator. He is the author of Kitabu al-Iqd al-Farid. بل وكان مؤثقا نبيلا بليغا شاعرا. He was a very reliable, truthful person. نبيل. نبيل is a person of honor, a respectable person, a person who has dignity. And he was very eloquent and a poet. In his book Al-Iqd al-Farid, volume number 4. Al-Iqd al-Farid, published at Dar al-Kutub al-Ilmiya, volume number 4, year 1404. At this book, page number 97. Again, the account of Amr ibn al-As. والله ما ثقلت علينا يومئذ وطأتك ولقد كشفت فيها عورتك. This same conversation between Abdullah ibn Abbas, the famous Sahabi, the cousin of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, and Amr ibn al-As, whereby Abdullah ibn Abbas reminds Amr ibn al-As that you are the same person who at the Battle of Siffin had exposed his behind in order to save his life. This is the book of Al-Imama wa Siyasa, written by Ibn Abdullah Ibn Muslim Ibn Qatiba Ibn Qutayba Ad-Dinawari. تاريخ الخلفاء والإمامة والسياسة تأليفه عبد الله ابن مسلم ابن قتيبة الدينوري. He passed away at year 276. الإمامة والسياسة. Published by أعلمي Foundation at year 1427. At this book and the Battle of Siffin, the accounts of Battle of Siffin, page 105. دعا علي عليه السلام معاوية إلى البراز. Historians have mentioned when the Battle of Siffin was prolonged after 40 days, Amir al-Mu'minin alayhi salam yaghduna ila al-qital wa yaruhun. Every 40 days there was battle in the daytime, and at the nighttime both armies would come to their camps. So every day there was battle for 40 days, very lengthy. Bali. Fa amma al-qital alladhi kana fihi al-fana fa thalathat ayyam. The heat of the battle that both parties engaged in battle and a lot of people died, that lasted 3 days. فَلَمَّا رَأَى عَلِيٌ عَلَيْهِ سَمْ كَثْرَةَ الْقِتَالِ وَالْقَتْلِ فِي النَّاسِ بَرَزَ يَوْمًا مِنَ الْأَيَّامِ وَمُعَاوِيَتُ فَوْقَ التَّلِ. When Amir al-Mu'minin alayhi salatu wasalam saw that the battle was prolonged and lengthy, one day he came out and saw that Muawiyah was on top of a hill. فَنَادَى عَلِيٌ بِأَعْلَى صَوْتِهِ. فأمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام called on معاوية with a very loud voice. يا معاوية. أو معاوية. فأجابه. فقال ما تشاء يا أبا الحسن. معاوية responded. What do you want? أو أبو الحسن. سلام الله على أمير المؤمنين. قال علي عليه السلام لما على ما يقتتل الناس ويذهبون. أمير المؤمنين عليه السلام said to معاوية. معاوية. Why are people being killed? Why are people fighting each other and dying? What's the reason? على ملك إن نلته كان لك دونهم. Are they dying because of a kingdom? Because of a government? If you succeed, if you're victorious, you will have the government, not them. It will not benefit them. وإن نلته أنا كان لي دونهم. And if I'm victorious, the government will be mine and not for the people, not, it will not belong to the people. أبرز إلي ودع الناس. You come to the battle. Leave the people alone. You come to my fight. فَيَكُونُ الْأَمْرُ لِمَنْ غَلَى. Whoever wins. Whoever wins. People do not fight each other in vain. So whoever wins, then he will be victorious. And then that'll be the end of this conflict. قَالَ أَمْرُ بْنِ الْعَاصِ أَنْصَفَكَ الرَّجُلُ يَا مُعَاوِيَةَ. Ibn al-As was there. He said to Muawiyah, he is ansaf al-rajul. He is, his call, his invitation is a fair call. A very fair and a very a manly invitation. فضحك Muawiyah. Muawiyah laughed وقال تمعت فيها يا عمر. Muawiyah laughed and said, Amr, you want to be the caliph after me? You want to send me to my death? فقال عمر والله ما أراه يجمل بك إلا أن تبارزه. عمر بن العاص said no معاوية. right now with the call that Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam has made, it's not, you don't have a choice. You have to go to his fight. You have to accept his challenge. فَقَالَ مُعَاوِيَةَ مَا أَرَاكَ إِلَّا مَازِحًا نَلْقَاهُ بِجَمْعِنَا. Muawiyah said, no, you're kidding me, right? We will both go to his fight. We both go to fight Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. وَذَكَرُوا أَنَّ عَمْرًا قَالَ لِمُعَاوِيَةَ أَتَجْبَنُوا عَنْ عَلِيٍّ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. بَلِ عَمْر said to Muawiyah, Muawiyah, are you scared of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam? Are you afraid? وَتَتَّهِمُنِي فِي نَصِيحَتِي إِلَيْكَ. And you are accusing me when I asked you to go to his fight because he's called on you, because it doesn't look good anymore if you do not accept this challenge. You're accusing me of being not being sincere. وَاللَّهِ لَأُبَارِزَنَّ عَلِيًا لَوْ مِتْتُ أَلْفَ مَوْتَةٍ فِي أَوَلِ لِقَائِهِ. So Amr ibn al-As said, since you are accusing me, I will go to his fight. Even if I'm killed 1,000 times, I will go to and fight him. فَبَارَزَهُ عَمْرٌ. So Amr ibn al-As came to fight Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. فَطَعَنَهُ عَلِيٌ عَلَيْهِ سَلَامٌ فَصَرَعَهُ. Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam struck Amr, struck perhaps with his sword. فَصَرَعَهُ. And the strike of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam threw Amr on the ground. فَاتَّقَاهُ بِعَوْرَتِهِ فَانْصَرَفَ عَنْهُ عَلِيٌ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. So Amr ibn al-As exposed his behind, turned around, exposed his behind. So Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam turned away and did not kill him. وكان علي عليه السلام لم ينظر قط إلى أورة أحد حياء وتكرما. أمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام had never glanced at any person's private parts because of his honor and because of his حياء. Because of his حياء. حياء is a word that's difficult to translate into English. وتنزها عما لا يحل ولا يجمل بمثله كرم الله وجهه. And because أمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام refrained from anything that was not appropriate for him, that was unbecoming to him. Though it was not appropriate for him, he would not do it. And looking at someone's private part was not appropriate for him. This is Sharh Nahj al-Balagha by Ibn Abi al-Hadid. Ibn Abi al-Hadid mentions this incident in his book, Sharh Nahj al-Balagha, Ibn Abi al-Hadid. Volume number 4. Published by Al-Amira in Beirut, Lebanon at the year 1428. قال نصر. He narrates from Nasr ibn Muzahim and Ibn Abbas. Ibn Abbas said, تعرض عمرو بن العاص لعلي يوما من أيام الصفين وظن أنه يطمع منه في غرة فيصيبه فحمل عليه علي عليه الصلاة والسلام فلما كاد أن يخالطه أذرى نفسه عن فرسه ورفع ثوبه وشغر برجله فبدت عورته فانصرف علي عليه الصلاة والسلام فصرف أمير المؤمنين عليه السلام وجهه عنه. One day in the battle of Siffin, Amr ibn al-As encountered Amir al-Mu'mineen عليه الصلاة والسلام وظن أنه يطمع منه في غرة فيصيبه. Amr ibn al-As thought that he perhaps could get a horse or something, that he would find a booty from the war. When Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam saw that, ghurra is a horse that has white forehead. So there was a white horse, beautiful horse, that Amr ibn al-As wanted to take it as a booty. Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam charged at Amr. فَلَمَّا كاد أن يخالطه. As soon as Amir al-Mu'mineen عليه السلام approached Amr, and it was close that Amir al-Mu'mineen عليه السلام would touch him, strike him, would have contact with him. أذرى نفسه عن فرسه. Amr ibn al-As threw himself down. This is the account narrated by Abdullah ibn Abbas. Amr ibn al-As threw himself down from the horse. ورفع ثوبه. And then he threw himself down on the ground, and then he pulled up his Arabian shirt, the dishdasha, the thawb that the Arabs wear. It's a very long robe from here to the ankles, here lifted up. وَشَغَرَ بِرِجْلِهِ And he lifted up his both legs. فَبَدَتْ عَوْرَتُهُ And his private parts, his rear side, if he's on his back and legs are up, and the shirt, and he pulls up the robe, of course, his private parts were exposed. فَصَرَفَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ وَجْهَهُ عَنْ أمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام بلي turned away from him وارتث وقام معرف معفرا بالتراب عمر بن العاص was very very disturbed very terrified he got up all his body was covered with dirt هاربا على رجلي he was running he forgot his horse running towards Muawiyah's camp معتصما بصفوفه he ran fast and until he arrived at the Muawiyah's army فقال أهل العراق يا أمير المؤمنين أفلت الرجل the army of أمير المؤمنين عليه السلام said to أمير المؤمنين عليه السلام you didn't kill him he ran away he got away from you فقال أتدرون من هو أمير المؤمنين عليه السلام said do you know who he is قالوا لا they said no قال فإنه عمرو بن العاص تلقاني بسوءته he is عمرو بن العاص he exposed his private parts فصرفت وجهي عنه and therefore I did not kill him that's why I didn't kill him ورجع عمرو إلى معاوية فقال ما صنعت يا أبا عبد الله معاوية عمرو بن العاص went to Muawiyah. Muawiyah said, what did you do today? What happened? فَقَالَ لَقِيَنِي عَلِيٌ عَلَيْهِ سَلَامُ فَصَرَعَنِي He said, oh yeah, I encountered Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. He threw me on the ground. He did not, Amr ibn al-As did not say everything. So Muawiyah said to him, أَحْمَدَ اللَّهُ وَعَوْرَتَكَ وَاللَّهِ إِنِّي لَأَظُنَّكَ لَوْ عَرَفْتَهُ لَمَا أَقْحَمْتَ عَلَيْهِ بلي. Muawiyah said to him, thank Allah and your private parts. Thank Allah and your private parts. I swear by Allah, if you knew this was Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam, you would have not gone to his fight. You have not gone to his proximity. وَقَالَ مُعَاوِيَ فِي ذَلِكَ And Muawiyah said a few lines of poetry in this. أَلَا لِلَّهِ مِنْ فَوَاتِ عَمْرٍ يُعَاتِبُنِي عَلَى تَرْكِ بِرَازِي بَلِي I'm amazed, by God, I'm amazed at Amr ibn al-As in his vain words. He rebukes me why I do not go to fight Amir al-Mu'minin عليه الصلاة والسلام. فَقَدْ لَاقَ أَبَا حَسَنٍ عَلِيًّا فَآبَ الْوَائِلِيُّ مَأْبَ خَازِي فلو لم يبدع عورته لطارت بمهجته قوادم أي بازي فإن تكن المنية أخطأته فقد غنى بها أهل العجاز فغضب عمرو فقال ما أشد تعظيمك عليا عليه السلام أبا تراب في أمري هل أنا إلا رجل لقيه ابن عمه فصرعه أفترى السماء قاتلة لذلك دما قال لا ولكنه معقبة لك خزيا عمرو بن العاص faced Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wasalam. However, he ran away. He ran away in such a escape that it will be a dishonor for him for ages to come. If he had not exposed his rear side, if he had not exposed his behind, his blood would have spilt in front of everybody in the battlefield. فَلَمْ تَكُنِ الْمُنْيَةُ أَخْتَأَتْهُ فَقَدْ غَنَّى بِهَا أَهْلُ الْعِجَازِ Amr ibn al-As did not escape death because every second from now on, this dishonor would be his death. And all the time, the people of Arabia would remind him of his escape and that he exposed his behind to Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wassalam. And that would be his dishonor. Amr ibn al-As was very angry and said, well, how, why do you have such great respect for Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam? Amr ibn al-As said to Muawiyah, in this story, in this incident, why you are praising Ali alayhi salam so much? هل أنا إلا رجل لقيه ابن عمي فصرع. I just met my cousin. My cousin threw me down. It's not a big deal. Nothing significant. أفترى السماء قاطرة لذلك دما. Do you think as the sky will rain blood? Blood? Would shed blood? Is it, it's not important. I had an encounter with my cousin. قال لا ولكنها معقبة لك خزية. Muawiyah said, no, a sky will not shed blood, but it would be for you a dishonor forever and ever. The reason I quote it to you, and this incident has been narrated in other books too. The reason I quote it to you, my dear friends, this incident is that I've been challenging the Umari scholars for debates. And all I see from them is turning away, running away, exposing their behinds. And this is a matter of great dishonor for the Umaris, that they continue that very same tradition set by Amr ibn al-As and Umar ibn al-Khattab of running away from facing the opponent. And I hope this, at least this call, would encourage some Umari and convince some Umari scholar to face me, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, for a debate. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجهم ولن أعداءهم يا علي مداد. اللهم كن لوليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.